Hi, welcome to this hint video. So the question that we're going to try and solve today is longer contiguous segments of ones than zeros. So this question was asked in the LeetCode contest 242 as question number one. And this question is very easy to understand. We are given a string, a binary string S, and we have to find whether the contiguous segment of ones is greater than zero or not. So if the contiguous segment of ones, the longest contiguous segment of one, is greater than the longest contiguous segment of zeros, then we have to return true, otherwise false. So as we can see in this example number one over here, we have a binary string 1101. So contiguous segment of one is this one over here and these two ones over here. Obviously, the longer one between them is this one, the one that I've selected as of now, and its length is 2, right? And the longest contiguous segment of 0 is only this, which gives us the length as 1. So since the longest contiguous segment of 1s is greater than the longest contiguous segment of 0, our answer is 2. Over here, the longest contiguous segment of 1 is of length 3, and for 0, it is also 3. Since 1 is not longer, but equal, so again, the answer is false. Let's look at an example that I've drawn over here. So in this example, we can clearly see that the longest contiguous segment of zeros is this, which is of length 3, and of ones is this, which is of length 4. So our answer will be true, as 4 is greater than 3, right? So I think our task is pretty much very easy. All we have to do is find the length of the contiguous segment. And let's say the length of contiguous segment of ones is, let's say, S1 is something and S2 is something. Let it be X, let it be Y. So all you have to do is return whether S1 is greater than S2. So S1 will return S2. So if this is true, you are going to return true. If this is false, you're going to return false, right? So this is the basic question. Now, all that remains is to, you know, find the length of the contiguous segments, and that should be very easy for us. So all we need to do is using a loop, what we can do is we are going to iterate over this string S, right? We are going to iterate over this string S, and let's say that we are maintaining, let's use 4 variables, okay? So one variable can be max 1 equal to 0. Other can be max 0, which will be equal to 0, right? For iteration, okay. So these will be maintaining the length of the largest contiguous segment that we have till now, right? And to find the length of the contiguous segment, we can maintain another two variables. Let's call them 1 and let's call them 0. Okay, initially both of them will be 0. Fine. So our job is pretty easy. Simply use a for loop. You can keep it a comprehensive loop if you want. Let me use a comprehensive loop with me. So for X in S, right? This is the format in Python. In C++, you can simply do for C++ in Java, I guess. For char X in S. So syntax doesn't matter over here. We need to understand the concept, right? So we're iterating over our string and, sorry, if X is equal to, in fact, 0, right? This would mean that 0 has zero needs to be increased, right? First thing that you need to do is zero plus plus, right? Second thing that you need to do is you need to make one as zero. Like this variable one, you will have to initialize it as zero. Why is it so? Suppose there was some segment that was ending over here, segment ending before this zero has been encountered. This means that the contiguous chain of ones has been broken. For example, you were counting these all and now a zero came. So this variable, it was increasing up till the point four maybe over here, right? And now this zero actually broke the chain. So we'll have to reinitialize one with zero so that next time one comes, it will again start from zero. And for this segment, its length will again be one, right? So this is the concept over here, as simple as that. First you need to do is increment zero. Other thing you need to do is set one as zero again. And third thing you need to do is in max zero, you will store the max of the current zero and the previously calculated max zero. Same will be followed for one when x is equal to one. So I think we can simply use an else over here. One, what you can do is one plus plus. Second, what we're going to do is set zero as zero now. Same reason. So let's say you were traversing these ones over here and you were traversing these zeros over here and you encountered this one. So for these zeros, the value of zero would have reached up till three and this contiguous segment of one just began. Since this contiguous segment is over, next time when you find another zero, you have to reinitialize it with zero, right? Initialize the counter variable with zero so that it does not build upon the three of this and make this four. So I think, yeah, this is clear. And I think third step would also be clear to you guys. It's that you'll have to initialize max one with max of previous max of one, previous max of one, comma, the current that you're actually calculating, which is one, right? So this was the code. All after running this loop, simply you have to return. What do you have to return? Max O greater than max Z. And this will give you the answer. So this was a very simple question. No trick or no, you know, there was no trick involved. There was no special algorithm that was being used. It's just plain conditional analysis over here, which you can find your correct answer. So I hope this was clear. Thank you.